Hello everyone, welcome to the world of engineers. Myself Hardik Patel and I am assistant professor of mathematics at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. I am going to teach you mathematics 1 in this semester. So first of all, we are going to see why the mathematics is important to learn for engineers and why we need to learn mathematics in engineering. First of all, what are the applications and why engineers need, at which places we are going to apply the mathematics, that we are going to see with the syllabus in this session. So first we are starting with the content. In a content there are 6 units. So in a 6 units, the first unit is a matrix. In a matrix you have already learned that the matrix is an array arrangement of any elements in some particular number of rows and particular number of columns. Here we are going to learn the matrix which you have already learned up to 3x3, but we are going to extend it for any number of rows and any number of columns. Now some of the topics here we have listed for the matrix, and whatever you have learned that we are going to extend here for some matrices and applications of matrix. So some of the applications we are going to see here. The first application is image processing. In image processing, we can apply the image processing to enhance the blur image or to increase the quality of image. And what we are going to do, we are going to consider each pixel as a one element and we are going to put it in a matrix as a one element at some particular number of row and column, and then using application of matrix we are going to enhance it, and then we are going to find new matrix and reduce it to the image again. That will give you the new enhanced image using image processing. That is a basically application of matrix. Same manner, second application is a cryptography. In a cryptography, we are using the matrix, binary matrix, and using it, we are going to encode and decode the programming, which is basically used in a coding language, and that will the application of the matrix in real world. Now, the second topic is a partial derivative. You have already learned the limit continuity and differentiation of one variable function, but we are going to learn it for multivariable function. So first we are going to define the multivariable function, and using multivariable function we are going to find the limit continuity and differentiability of that multivariable function which you have not learned up to 12th. Here we are going to find out the multivariable function and how to find the limit continuity and differentiation of them. Here are some of the topics we have listed here for partial derivatives, such as a chain rule, implicit function, total derivative, and some of the applications of partial derivative. The first application we are going to learn how to draw the graph of multivariable function. Here it is a graph of multivariable function. You can see how to draw it, and in 3 dimension you get the curve or surface like this. Same manner, secondly, the application of partial is to find the extreme values, that is the maximum and minimum. Here we can see whatever the maximum peak you have, that are the top peaks are big maximum values and the bottom peaks are minimum values. Same manner, the last application we are going to see here is a tangent. So how to find the tangent plate at any point, that will be the application. In 2D you have a tangent line, in 3D we have a tangent plane, and the normal to the tangent, that will be the normal to the surface at a point. Now the third topic we are going to see is a sequence and series. You have learned the sequence and series for finite number of terms. You have learned how to find the sum of a series up to finite terms or finite number of terms using sequence. But Here we are going to extend it for infinite number of terms. That means now we are going to find the infinite term of a sequence and infinite sum of a series. What is the applications? Before going on to that, these are the some of the topics which we are going to cover in a sequence and series. First one is a convergence and divergence. Some of the tests, how to find the convergence and divergence. And we are going to learn particular form of a particular form of an infinite series, which is called a power series. That is, a power series is nothing but it is a series in a form of x minus a. That means it contains the terms with x minus a and its powers. That series, and using the power series, what we are going to do, we are going to find the Taylor and Maclaurin series, which is a particular form of power series. Now, what are the applications of sequence and series? First, we are going to check here. I am going to give you the bouncing ball example. You can see in the figure that the wherever the ball bounces and it touches the ground, then wherever it touches the ground, that will form one sequence, and it will be going to be touched after some time at particular point. So this is called an infinite sequence, which is going to be formed in a real world problem. Secondly, we are going to see how to form the Taylor series and what are the applications and why we are using it. So here in a graph, you can see that if you are going to find the Taylor series and you are going to find term next one by one, then you get the exact value of a curve in some particular region. Using this Taylor series, we can find the approximate value of a function in a particular region up to certain decimal places. And using the Taylor and Maclaurin series, what the computer programming can be done, as well as we can find out the approximate value without using calculator and scientific calculator. Now the third for next topic will be a Fourier series. That will Fourier series is the series which is a sine and cosine expansion, infinite sine and cosine expansion of function which is periodic. Now if it is periodic function, then we can find the Fourier series, which is expressed in the form of sine and cosine. Some of the topics we are going to cover in the Fourier series are given in a form given here. And secondly, why we are going to introduce the Fourier series, because we need it to find the in a signal transformation, and we are going to see some of the applications like a Schottuth wave generation. Here we can have a Schottuth for wave generation. If you are going to increase the number of n's, then whatever the term, whatever your function is going to be fit exactly to the Schottuth wave, and you get the exact transformation. Same manner, the next one application is a square wave generation, and square wave generation is given here. It is generated by sinusoidal function. So this is the Fourier series and some of the applications. Now the next topic we have is the indeterminate form and application of integration. Now up to 12th you have learned the definite integrals and some of the applications of definite integrals, but here we are going to learn some particular form of definite integrals, and we are going to extend it for applications of integrals. First we are going to learn the improper integrals, then we are going to learn beta and gamma function, and then we are going to learn what are the applications of single integrals. So some of the applications here we are going to see is, the first one is a method of volume by the method of washer method. In washer method, what we are going to, we find the volume by rotation about some axis. If you are taking the cross section, then that will give you the curve like a washer. That's why this method is called a washer method. And then second method is a slicing method. In a slicing method, we are going to add all slice cut. That means we are taking a cross section perpendicularly to the axis, and we are going to find out the cross section area, and we are going to add them all. That will give you the volume in three dimension. Same method, the last method is the shell method. Here we are, if you are rotating about some axis, then you will get the shell region. And if you are going to add all of them, then that will give you the shell region, and that will give you the volume in three dimensions. Now, last, we are going to find, last topic is the multiple integral. Now up to 12th, you have learned definite integrals, and you have learned the definite integral for a single variable. You have learned it, how to integrate it, and you can integrate it any number of times. But here we are going to learn the double integration. Double integration is, or triple integration is basically applied for multivariable function. That means now you are not integrating with respect to only one variable, you are integrating with respect to more than one variables. So some of the topics we have listed here, some of them are like a double integration over rectangular region, then triple integration, then application of some of the integration, and we are going to change the regions in a different type of coordinate system. Now the first application we are going to see is the area. Now here we have given the surface area. You can also find the simple area by double integration. Same manner, the next application is the volume. In a volume, you can find the volume by double integration as well as by triple integration. So let us see the syllabus weightage. At last we are going on to the weightage of syllabus, of our syllabus. The first unit has a 15% weightage, second unit has a 20% weightage, third unit has a 20% weightage, fourth unit has a 10% weightage, and fifth unit has a 15% weightage, and the last unit, which is a multiple, has a 20% weightage. This is the weightage according to the GTO syllabus. Thank you for listening me. If you have any doubts or query, then you feel free to contact me.